about 2.5 miles from our customer. Might start the video about a mile out. Like all cars. Oh boy, if I come in here, I'm gonna be upset if. Oh no, we weren't supposed to do this. This is wrong. Can I back up? Four-ways on. It says we're supposed to be on. That's why. Okay. If I come in here, I can't get out. Let me just back out of this mess. We're clear. Nobody's behind us. Let me just rethink this for a minute. I did not see the customer name on that board up front, so yeah, we don't want to come in here. And I don't think there's enough room to turn around, is there? Got it. 3-4-1-1-2-3-4-3-3. We're looking for 3-2-0-0, so definitely not going to make it. Let me do this. Let me get over here a little bit this way. If the transmission can figure out what gear to be in. Definitely don't want to drive in there, dude. That's Nothing but cars are parked in. This is not a trucking place. Even if it was, it's the numbers don't match our customer. This is what makes an interesting video, right? I see evidence of trucks doing hard U-turns out of here, so. It's got tracks on the ground. This transmission, I tell you. It's a good transmission, except when you're dead stopped and it doesn't know what gear to be in. I think we have to go down that road. So we're going to do that real quick. Regatta Boulevard. Okay, that's what I missed. She was... Either she told me to make a left or I didn't hear it or something. It could have been the CB. Messed me up. Whoops, that's my fault. Rider in a red is legal in California. I'm trying to get over there before 10. I got a current time is 9:45. Trains are coming. Let's see the elevators. Ding, 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 ding. All right, so that would be the ultimate, you know, like we had gone into the wrong driveway and then backed out and then the train came and delayed me even more. You know, that's kind of like my luck. If it weren't for bad luck, I wouldn't have no luck at all. All right, so 3200 Regatta. Definitely glad we did not go in there. Look at that. What a mess. I would have, oh man, there's definitely no trucks in there. Some kind of office building. Okay, she says, that. Oh, 0.3 of a mile. It's up here on the left. Legit.
Approaching destination in 1/4 mile. On the right side.
Okay, that might be it. This might be the entrance. 3200 straight ahead. 32 A and E F this way. F is this way. Sweet F. Okay, looking for sweet F. And it's my own fault for not looking on Google Maps and, you know, zooming in on where I'm supposed to go. I don't do that stuff. I'm too old. I can't be learning new tricks. I'm older than Google, dude. That's a joke I saw on I saw on Facebook.
Approaching destination in 700 feet on the right side.
I'm sure, how sweet is this? Sweet F is in the middle. D, you see Delta. Where's the F on that? That's what I'm trying to figure out if we can win this gate. I guess we can come in and. It's big enough to turn around in. Is there an F here? I didn't see one. But I can turn around and get out if necessary. Sweet E, F, no, A. Why are the letters out of order, man? There's D, E, and A. Why? Well, maybe there isn't enough time. Oh boy, okay, hang on a second. That's D, and that's E, so that would tell me you go down further, you run into F, but you know what? It's A is the next letter, so I'm a little bit confused. And again, my fault, I should have done some more research. Let's go down the road here a little bit and see if... Coming into a customer like this slows things down a little bit. It gets me off the main road. I think it's further down here. Over this hill complex is Cogent. It says looking for F. Maybe it's that next wing.
You have arrived at your destination on the right side, 3200 Regatta Boulevard.
I'm hoping there's a I don't see any letters. And I don't see a driveway to get in there either, so I'm confused. And if I have to go around and turn, how am I supposed to get into this place, is my question. Surely. Okay, it still says an arrow going this way for my customer. C. Letters are going down, so D, C. What's this? It's got to be here. We have to go in here, right? Let's see what this is. F, sweet F. Okay, perfect. Go nice and wide. Thankful that there's not a heavy-duty traffic going up and down and making me wait for, making them wait for me. I hate people waiting up for me. Okay, coaching. Park over here out of the way and then walk up. You see that Saya truck? That's funny. They knew exactly where they were going. Where do I check in? Probably where the truck is. Should we get behind that truck and block the world? Or just park way over here and walk over there? Stepping out a little bit. Let me get my vest. We gotta do the Ryvac customer thing. Call time real quick. Change to on duty. We'll do Ryvac customer. See, there goes, that guy's gonna jump in front of me too, is he not? Possibly. I got a pre-plan already. Arrive at final customer, send. Yes, let's read the pre-plan says, Stockton, California picks up 11/28. I'm not sure what the date is today even. Today's the 28th, picks up at noon and it goes to Tacoma, Washington a couple days from now, all right. I got a problem with, I don't have a calendar anymore, you know my. I had to turn in my truck to the mechanics, and then I got it. They got me a new truck, this truck. And you know, my calendar that I had on the dash is in the old truck. So. But the good news is, it's almost December. In December of every year, usually the TAs, Petros, and various truck stops around the country will start putting out their annual calendars. The ones that stick to the dash right here. So I'm gonna pick one up this week, probably. And yeah. Let's go in and check in, party pooch. See what they say. Let's go check it out. Let's go check in, rather. Appointment is 10 a.m. tomorrow, but hopefully they'll take us today. G, where's F? That's not all the way. That's G right there. So where the fudge is F? It could be down further. And I'm at the totally wrong place. Excuse me. Do you know if F is further down? Can't hear me. They're totally ignoring. Truckers ignore each other. You guys know if Sweet F is further down this way?
What?
Sweet F? This is Sweet G right here. Do you know the sweets?
You might have to go around the back.
You might have to go around. This building has two sides.
Yeah, that was D and C and A over there. I'm looking
for. What are you looking for?
And the sign out here says F is on this side.
Cogent is F.
Okay, well, it says G.
I know.
Let me go check in and see what they say. I appreciate
your help. What are you doing, delivery?
Yeah.
It's the next steps.
Okay.
We'll call it the block steps.
Oh, right on.
No, we'll call it receiving delivery.
Oh, receiving, I see. Oh, Sweet F is right here, it says. Okay. I just didn't see the letter. Thank you, Bob. Receiving. Yeah, Sweet F.
Just ring the doorbell. Somebody will come
Right here? Okay, bud. Thank you.
Ring the doorbell.
It'd be helpful if they had a big F up here on the building, right? Big giant F. I got a delivery. Well, he said ring the doorbell, somebody will come. You know how it is.
Yeah. Hey, you got a guy waiting already.
Right. Oh, we can come in and wait.
Yes, sir.
Says Doc 10 over there. Two, seven, it's on the other, between those guys. So let me figure out how I want to do this. Oh, just go up that way and then back in. I think it'll be fine. Yeah. All right, let me go open my door. Get ready. Oh, I got that seal. I gotta cut my seal. Get some tools. Oh, something smells good out here. That wrench. Oh, I know where it is. All right, let's get this thing cut open and dock it in number 10. Super easy, easy dock. Very light load. I think this load is only 12,000 pounds. I came across Wyoming in the slick roads. There was, on this trip, we had a lot to contend with. There was 32 trucks and cars, and mostly trucks, wrecked out. It was piled up. Wyoming, I'm trying to remember the exit number. It was like right by the rest area, over there by 323, exit mile marker 323. Dude, I've done that so many times. Drove off with my, left my tools on the tailgate. And it sucks, man. Sucks having to go buy a new tool. All right, so yeah, I was gonna say that we're coming through Wyoming and I could feel the road was slick as an ice skating rink. And I slowed down and I set my inner axle locks. And I was going about 38 miles an hour, 40, you know, keeping it right around close to 40. And I was being passed up by tons of trucks, truckers passing me up. You know, you can tell by the body language of their truck, which is a joke, you can't tell. But you could tell they were driving by like as if, you know, they consider you a rookie. Get out of my way, rookie. Don't you know how to drive? Oh, yes, sir. Okay. Let's get you on the, out here. Get some stuff. Well, actually, can I put you, let me try this. Let me do this. We're going to try something different. Put you up here. How's that? Yeah. That'll work. Baby. check something real quick? It's a teaching moment too. Let me slide the tabs all the way back just for. But I wanted to walk back here and show you something. You see these right hidden by this flappy thing. This bracket right here will rip your doors right off if you're not careful. If you were to back in and your hinges hit that bracket, if your door were to hit that, it would just break your door right off. And this one is brightly colored and painted. When I was back in my seat, I thought this was where they wanted me to bump into. And then as I got closer, I saw this. These are the actual bumpers. And that's why I wanted to, really just what I wanted to show you there is these brackets. Especially this one is hidden. And the little tape is faded, you can't see it, la la la. And it's easy to make a bad mistake. And you gotta be cognizant and careful of that stuff. And it's always important to get out and look, G-O-A-L. Get out and look and ensure that everything is where you want it. So let me put this back here, I think. So where can I put you guys? Right here is good. Good to go?
Yeah.
You like it?
Hold on, let me bring this up. Okay.
Make sure it comes up, and yeah. If I need to move forward, let me know.
Okay, I'm gonna do that right now.
Okay.
Love you good.
All right, thank you, bud. Easy money. All right, so we'll get this load kicked off. We got to go back to Stockton, we're in San Richmond, California. We got to go back to Stockton, California and pick up my next load. It looks like it has 2 days on it. Let me trip plan it real quick. 764 paid miles on the next one. So, let me think. I'm trying to think if I have enough time to go home and spend a night at home again. Or should I just make tracks? What I need to do is I got to get up to Portland, Oregon and pick up a sticker for the license plate. Now the registration is expiring on the truck. November 30th, that's a couple days. the day this delivers. So I actually just answered my own question. I need to go pick up the load and get moving as far north as I can.
Oh, we're out. Okay, thank you, Bob. Oh, 6 units. It's on the back in the market. All right, thank you, Bob.
Cool. All right, that's good. All right, we'll figure it out. It says, six units short. It's better than being over, I guess. Last time I had an overage, I had to take it with me and dispose of it at my own discretion. So. All right, so let's slide these tandems back to the 40-foot mark, California. And do something else. Shut the doors. We gotta go pick up another load down here in Stockton. Get the GPS cooking. I already punched in the address. All right, let me go close those doors real quick. Help. 6 units short, man. Slide them forward, and we'll get the heck out of here. Oh, I got a message already. I think it's one of those. Now empty, go to the truck stop and scan your stuff in message, you know, the canned. Oh no, we got the full pre-plan. I'm sorry, the full dispatch. All right, so this says we're gonna be arriving at 1 p.m. and the appointment on this thing says 12 noon. You gotta be there no later than 12 noon. I'm not worried about it because it is a preloaded trailer. So we don't have to wait or anything. We're just gonna go in there and sign the bills. Been there many times, I know what the deal is. They may even have the paperwork in the box out front. Sometimes they have that. You pull the paperwork out of the box, sign it, leave them a copy, take yours and go. But that's after hours, so we don't know. We're gonna find out together. Hey, throw a Flying J, get fuel. Oh, no. See, what they don't know is what I know. And I know that Lathrop Flying J is easy to get in, impossible to get out. That's your bobtail. I stopped there the other day and got my shower before I went home because Renee had guests and I didn't want to walk in there. Get a shower, you know, with guests in the house. I didn't want to do that, so I just went and got my shower before I went home. And, I was bobtail, so I was able to get in and get out pretty quick. No problems. Yeah. Took forever to kick in. Let me go have a look at it, make sure it's legal. Because it should have kicked in sooner than that. Slow. Deployment of pins. Slow. Might be lucky here. Oh yeah, we're good. See the 40-foot mark? We're good. Well, that's another case where you can't really trust. I think it's close enough. You got to get out and look on those things like that, because cannot afford to be wrong on various things in this job. You gotta be, it's only 70 foot walk, 150 foot walk round trip more or less. Just get out there and do it. Get your butt, lazy butt out there and walk back there. And walk back there. And for me, I'm the laziest truck driver out here, man. I'm like, not filming it, I probably just wouldn't go and not worry about it. But yeah, you know, whatever. Okay, let's go make some money. Let's get on it. Make some of that cash. This road. Okay, the freeway's right there. Can we get to the freeway this way is the question. I don't think so. I think we're just going to go to the truck going. I got to wait for this truck. I just wanted to make sure he was not going to cut his path. I'm not sure where that road goes. truck to be courteous, and now I got burned. Brilliant. Burned by a red light. Thing you should be doing is